donation, and it shows the kind of leadership, international leadership, that Taiwan has already shown, and something that the world could use and learn from, that leadership.
那么我们对这个美国会持续会用美国的话语权以及投票权确保台湾参与国际组织。那我刚刚在会晤当中也有对蔡总统表达感谢，就是蔡总统提到要捐款100万美元给WHO，对抗在非洲爆发的伊波拉病毒，认为这是一个非常慷慨的举动，也展现出台湾的卓越的领导能力，而且我想这个方面这种领导能力是全世界都应该要学习的。
Well, thank you. We are very honored to be able to open a new American Institute in Taiwan, and it shows, I think, our commitment and our full and robust commitment to Taiwan and our relationship. I know there will be members who will be able to participate. I'll make sure I translate to the White House your desire to have Ambassador Bolton in attendance. But it goes to the very heart of what we just passed legislation, the Taiwan Travel Act, which is efforts by the United States to encourage high-level visits at the highest levels of the American government to Taiwan to express our further support. But I think just the fact that we're opening this new facility highlights the incredible partnership that we already have.
Any more questions?
那么，AIT 的这个新馆的开幕也表达展现出了美国对于台湾的承诺。那我知道绝对会有美国的人员来参与。那我也会向白宫转达，就是希望国家安全顾问波顿能够出席。那么我想这也是机会，有机会让我们实行这个刚通过的台旅法。我们希望通过台旅法鼓励美国高层官员来台湾。那么。 不过，我想就是光是AIT新馆的开幕就已经证实我台美关系的坚强。
Could you give us some examples in terms of the strengthening measures between the U.S. and Taiwan in terms of the cooperation that we might see coming in light of China's pressure?
Yeah, I think it's a great question in terms of in light of China's pressure. I think what the United States must do is to make sure that we stand up for businesses around the globe so they won't be bullied by Chinese attempts like we've seen lately with airlines and hotels, that we have to make sure that we stand up against those bullying efforts. And that we highlight Taiwan's international leadership. Taiwan is an example to China of great international leadership. That we use our voice and our vote and our support to international organizations, the United Nations, World Health Association, excuse me, the World Health Assembly through the World Health Organization to make sure that Taiwan is participating, has substantive participation, and where appropriate that, I guess, the joining of those organizations to make sure that this voice, this great Taiwan voice, is a part of it because of the leadership need. We've also introduced legislation called the Taiwan International Participation Act. That's bipartisan legislation to promote that participation. We've recently passed, as I mentioned, the Taiwan Travel Act, and we just introduced the Asia Reassurance Initiative as well. Sorry about that.
在面临中国的这种国际企业不要受到中国的霸凌，那么台湾的展现出来的领导能力其实是中国应该要学习的。那我们美国会持续用我们的话语权，用我们的投票权，不断的支持台湾的国际参与，像是参与这个世界卫生大会。台湾是非常有力的一个角色，能够贡献许多。那么。 具体的措施呢，包含我提出的这个台湾国际参与的法案，就是有受到跨党派支持的。另外还有台旅法以及亚洲再保证倡议，这些都是一些我们加强对台湾支持的一些举措。
Concerning the Taiwan International Participation Act, just mentioned that American government will use its voice and vote to help try and get more involved. I'm just wondering how specifically do you help Taiwan to get involved in such as WJA and specific examples, like how will you do it? And do we anticipate that the Chinese government will have protests against such a
Well, the Taiwan International Participation Act and the other legislation that we've introduced actually has the United States talking directly to China talking directly to China about that participation, making sure that we are upfront with China about our support for Taiwan. And then we encourage other organizations around the world to embrace and support and include Taiwan. At the World Health Assembly, the United States Secretary Azar mentioned Taiwan in his opening remarks at the World Health Assembly. We also know that Secretary Azar, I believe, met with the Taiwan group that attended as part of a meeting as well. And we will vote in organizations to include the participation and encourage invitations to Taiwan to participate. So this is very much a proactive effort by the United States.
You mentioned Secretary
Azar mentioned that. Secretary Azar of the Health and Human Services. And several of us, both Republican and Democrat members of the Senate, sent a letter recently to U.S. Airlines, CEOs of U.S. Airlines, encouraging them to not surrender to the bullying of China over their website and inclusion of Taiwan.
那么我们最近参议院的这个民主党以及共和党的议员都有联合致函给这个美国的航空公司，希望他们不要屈服于中国的霸凌跟改对于他们网站上对台湾的这个名称的表示方式。Okay, due to time constraint, we'll take one more question.
Are you concerned about provoking a backlash from China from the renewed support under the Taiwan Travel Act? And what's your understanding of President Trump's support for Taiwan at this stage?
I think the administration has significant and tremendous support for Taiwan. That was expressed at the earliest stages of President Trump's election and throughout his inaugural period. So I think as it relates to China and concern for China, we've made it very clear to China our great relationship with our ally, Taiwan. And I think that will continue. The fact is this, and simple, Taiwan has an important voice that needs to be included globally, and we will continue to stand up for that day in and day out.
Okay.
And finally, I have introduced along with Senators Rubio, Senator Cardin, Senator Markey, a bill known as the Asia Reassurance Initiative Act. The Asia Reassurance Initiative Act focuses on a free and open Indo-Pacific. Taiwan is very much at the core of a free and open Indo-Pacific. Within the legislation, it talks about our relationship and our strengthening of our relationship with Taiwan, including a routinization of arms sales and other opportunities for high-level business.
那么我们和我和其他的这个参议员提出的亚洲再保证倡议里面有提到自由开放的印态的这个策略。那么自由开放的印态呢，其实当中台湾也扮演一个非常关键的角色。那我们在这个法案当中也有提到和台湾的关系会不断的加强，其中还包含我们必须要将美国对台的军售常态化。
Okay, well,
thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes.
谢谢大家。